Have you ever wondered about what is fire protection all about? Especially nowadays wherein the local authorities require most, if not all, buildings with fire protection systems. You can see these in red color-coded system in malls, offices, factories and more. If you do so, sit back and relax as we will tackle about the basics of fire protection systems. Fire protection systems. Fire protection system are mainly categorized in three: fire fighting system, fire alarm system, and emergency life safety. Fire fighting system is designed to save the building or property. The simplest type of fire fighting is fire blanket or fire bucket, as it is used to stop the spread of fire, thus saves the property. The other common types of fire fighting system are a fire extinguisher system, fire hose reels and fire hydrants for manually operated, while automatic fire sprinkler system and gas system are automatic systems. Fire alarm system is designed to save the people inside the building. In case of fire, the system will alert the people so that they can evacuate the building as soon as possible if the fire cannot be stopped already. Although there might be a false alarm during this, it is still necessary to practice precautions until declared safe by the responsible person. Fire alarm system can also be automatically or manually triggered. Manual call point and break glass are examples of manually operated detectors, while smoke and heat detectors are automatic system devices. Other primary components of fire alarm system are sounders like siren with flush, fire alarm bells, horns, and call command center. We will all tackle these all in details in the next lectures. Emergency life safety. It is designed for other factors needed to ensure overall safety during a fire incident. These includes fire safety plan or evacuation plan, means of egress, emergency lights and signage, fire safety tips, and lots more. Most design engineers overlook this category, while it plays a major role in overall safety of the working area. Fire protection system will be designed in accordance to National Fire Protection Association, NFPA. NFPA is a set of standards and guide for fire-related safety in various subjects depending on situation and cases. NFPA's code and standard-making process began in 1896, when a small group of concerned professionals met in Boston to address the inconsistencies in the design and installation of fire sprinkler systems. At that time, there were 9 different standards for piping size and sprinkler spacing, and these business people realized that unless these discrepancies were resolved, the reliability of these sprinkler systems would be compromised. Working together, this small group created a standard for the uniform installation of sprinkler systems, which became the blueprint for NFPA 13, Standard for the Installation of Sprinkler Systems. The NFPA's codes and standards making process had begun. For more than 100 years, NFPA has been developing and updating codes and standards concerning all areas of fire safety. An international, non-profit, membership organization, NFPA's mission is to reduce the worldwide burden of fire and other hazards on the quality of life by providing and advocating consensus codes and standards, research, training, and education. While NFPA is involved with extensive fire research and produces numerous fire safety educational programs and materials, its lifeblood is its codes and standards making system. Currently, there are some 300 NFPA codes and standards used throughout the world. We will tackle this lesson step by step in the next lectures. Please don't forget to subscribe and like the video. So again, greetings of peace.